sea, rising at the break of day, brightly shining beams of sunshine, chasing all our cares away. And as the sun goes down in another little town, you can hear the people say,
picture show man, we want to see the things we've never seen, all shining on the silver screen. Oh, picture show man, turn off the lights and chase our cares away. Picture show man, give us a hero and a heroine to lift us from the world we're in. Oh,
smile when skies are gray. Give them little dreams to live for. Then pack up and drive away. And as the sun goes down in another little town, you can hear the people say,
picture show man, we want to see the things we've never seen, shining on the silver screen. Oh, picture show man, turn off the lights and chase our cares away. Picture show man, give us a hero and a heroine to lift us from the world we're in. Oh, picture show man, turn off the lights and chase our cares away.
This when you took me on.
How did I know it was going to be wet? It hasn't been wet here for years.
Oh, heard that one before.
You cannot expect this horse to pull three full-grown men with all that gear through this. Come, come,
come on. Why doesn't he buy another horse?
He likes to economize.
You mean he's stingy.
Walk. To make your own son walk, you have to let a dog ride.
If you want the dog off, you put him off.
Too right, I will.
Free man, you can chuck it any time you like.
Chuck it? Here?
You brought me out here, and you bloody well take me back. But the day we get back to town, I quit.
Pop!
What is it? Palmer.
Palmer?
What's upsetting him? A chap who used to be Pop's projectionist.
I gave him his first chance in show business as a spools boy. I taught him projection. I taught him how to handle louts. I taught him how to evade the tax man. The whole art of showmanship.
He's got his own outfit, has he?
I thought he was working a different territory.
Damn Yankee.
Meeting you, Mr. Pym.
What are you doing in these parts?
Oh, just passing through.
It's a long way from anywhere to be just passing through.
Well, you just look around you. It's a real nice country.
If you're thinking of moving into this territory, my boy, you think about moving out right now.
Oh, now, Mr. Pym, what's the harm in me picking up a couple of little towns here and there?
It's been mine for years, and you know it.
Well, just what in the hell are you going to do about it?
I've spent many years building up a following here.
You going to spread rumors about me? Like you did about old man Parker during the war? What was it you said? That he did time in Long Bay jailhouse? Anyway, it's been a real pleasure, Mr. Penn.
See you.
Yeah, what do you want?
Would you be able to carry a passenger?
You're his penis, don't you?
I was.
Could be looking for a job?
As a matter of fact, I am.
Why don't you just climb aboard, son? Easy now.
Hey, Palmer! He can't even play in bloody time!
But he was our pianist.
Well, we shall get another in town.
Summers is the name, Mr. Pym. A pleasure.
Have you ever played for pictures before?
Well, actually, I haven't yet had that opportunity. Dancing classes have been my specialty. Classical dancing, of course.
Yes, classical, of course. You play very beautifully. But I am afraid that I cannot give you the job. You're a lady of refinement. You're used to living comfortably. Out on the road, it's very rough. Traveling from town to town in all weathers, you take what you can in the way of accommodation.
I quite understand, Mr. Pym.
Well, the show must go on, you know. But if circumstances permit, I do intend setting up a permanent picture theatre of my own, and then, oh, things will be so different if I could get in touch with you then. My dear Mrs. Summers. Oh.
Mr. Pym, it would be a pleasure to hear from you.
Well,
No pianist, no music.
No music, no show. I don't think it was a good idea to let Lou go.
Let Lou go, he went. Can you only play chopsticks?
Right. You want me to be the pianist too? As well as feeding the horse, greasing the axle, patching the film, running the projector?
So sorry to get away.
I had another piano to do a few miles out.
The way some people let their instruments go, you wouldn't believe.
Needs tightening, definitely.
You are a piano tuner.
Well, I am considered an expert.
I wanted a picture pianist. Come, son. Come on.
Freddie Graves, late of the Roxy Theatre, Hornsby.
Got the job?
Well, I've never been with a travelling show before.
Oh, you'll love it. The open road, change of scene, the finest accommodation, good food. You know, some places have never had a piano tuner through for donkey's years.
Well, it depends on your offer. Well, I had an offer from Sydney a few days ago.
Oh, well, I can meet that. Money isn't everything. This could lead to bigger things. As soon as circumstances permit, it is my intention to set up a picture theater of my own in a big town. If I get the right proposition. Valuable thing that a travelling showman can have, besides his equipment.
His horse?
No.
His van?
No.
His assistant?
No.
His piano player?
No. His itinerary. It takes a lot of hard work to work out a good itinerary, a lot of local knowledge. You have to know the good roads, the crook roads, the good towns, bad towns.
Damn contraptions. I saw a picture show van the other day. Ran me off the road with my bike.
Hey, Palmer?
You know, when someone starts poaching on your itinerary, that's trouble. There's a man with a big hat. Two horses. Didn't even stop. I might have been killed.
You know, you'd think there'd be plenty of room for both of us in a few 100,000 square miles. I would be content just with a reasonable living, but Palmer, no. Not Palmer, he's so ambitious he'd bust a gut to get ahead of his own shadow.
Funny thing about towns, they've got a personality. You can sense it as soon as you drive into them. Some towns can give you a great welcome. Yay, the picture! lot of narcs. They want twice the whole rental you'd pay anywhere else, and they want it in advance. But not this town, no. This is a very nice town. This is a very playable town, very friendly town.
What's in that?
Oxygen.
Oxygen. What's in that?
Industrial ether.
Oxygen and ether. That's lethal.
Oh, not if you know what you're doing.
Sergeant, you're having a look at our plant.
Well, I thought these things were dangerous.
Ah! My dear fellow, I've been in the picture show business for 20 years, and I've never lost a customer.
Well, the last town I was in, they had an electric generating plant.
Electric? I wouldn't have one if I won it in a raffle.
Why not?
Electricity, too dangerous. It could kill a man.
These things could explode. The whole place could go up.
Electricity can start a fire at any time. Apart from all that, it is too hard on the eyes, you see. Limelight is very soft on the eyes. You ask any audience about that. Why don't you come and see it for yourself, Sergeant? Bring your wife and, do you have you, four kiddies, huh? And that means whenever that we're in town. Four.
I am the wind that will stir in the night as the light from your lamp warmly glows. I am the bird that you watch in its flight. You are longing to go where it goes. I'm a desert princess chic. You are a woman frail and weak. I want to pinch you on the cheek. Because I love you.
Is there anything wrong with my singing?
Nothing at all.
Most people say that's the best part of the show.
Well, it's just the song.
I've sung that song for 20 years, and nobody has complained.
Well, I'm sure it's still very popular, but if I may make a suggestion, why don't you try one of the more recent hits? Something like, tap, tap on my window. Could it be that you are still in love with me? Here we go again. Here we go again. Knock, knock on my door now. Could it be that you don't want to set me free? Here we go again. Here we go again.
Could it be that you are still in love with me? Here we go again. Here we go again. Knock, knock on my door. Or could it be that you don't want to set me free? Here we go again. Here we go again. You are by my side in spirit. In my lonely room I see your face. Then I hear it ring, ring on my bell. Or could it be that you are still in love with me? Here we go again.
here we go. Could be in my ears, or could it be that you don't want to set me free? Here we go again. Here we go again. You are by my side in spirit. In my lonely room, I see your face. And then I hear it. On my window, could it be that you are still in love with me? Here we go again. Here we go again. Knock, knock on my door, or could it be you do not want to set me free? There we went again. There we went again. We went.
I see.
Thank you.
Hasn't been tuned for some time.
Not since my husband died.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
He used to attend to things like that. So difficult to get anyone in these parts.
Well, we'll have to see what we can do. You play, I see.
I love music dearly.
Me too, it's my life.
I'm starved for musical companionship in this town. I heard you play last night.
You were there. What if I'd only realized?
So beautifully.
You know, playing for the picture show is a very special art, if I may say so. Some people think you can just strum at any old thing. You know, I once went to a picture theater and saw From the Manger to the Cross. When it got to the scene where Jesus was walking across the water, the pianist struck up Life on Ocean Way. Now, what you have to do is make the audience feel the right emotion at the right time.
Your repertoire must be tremendous.
The music can practically create the picture. For instance, Mysterioso. We use this for burglary scenes, creepy business. Shut your eyes. What do you see?
A haunted house.
Agitato, Mysterioso. What does that suggest?
I think coming action.
Very perceptive. And now... plaintive. We use this for feeling. Feeling too deep for words.
The music says it so much better. You make film music so fascinating. I had no idea there was so much science to it.
And feeling, Mrs. Duncan, sensitivity, is very important. And now to work. I shall have to take the front off.
Anything you find necessary. Take your time. Tea, Mr. Graves?
Thank you.
It's a very lovely instrument you have there. Some get all slack and sloppy, but yours was very firm to the touch. Very responsive.
We so rarely get people of your expertise in this part of the world.
Well, the only real trouble is time. I'm due at the hall to prepare for the show tonight.
Well then, tomorrow?
Unfortunately, we have to leave at daybreak for another town.
Oh.
There is one solution.
Yes?
I don't want to cause you any inconvenience.
Not at all. It is so important.
I could finish up after the show.
Wouldn't you be better off keeping that stuff in the bank, Mr. Pym?
No. No. It doesn't suit my way of life. This and this is my bank.
Well, how do you keep a check on your money?
Oh, I have a perfectly good accounting system. I can tell to a penny how much is in the kitty.
Cheers.
Oh, help on yourself.
A four in hand.
War. That's what it is. A dirty picture war.
We can't compete with that, Pop.
If he wants war, we shall give him war. I still think that I can show him a trick or two. Stop. I have bought a new horse.
Old horse, more like it.
What are you talking about? A bit of grooming and feeding and we'll have a nice pair. It'll certainly show promise.
How much?
Oh, a bargain.
How much of a bargain?
Oh, £4 and a couple of tickets to the show.
That's what I call a bargain. Well, even at £4, I'd say you were robbed.
Well, you two wouldn't know a good nag if it bit you. I tell you, this horse has got breeding.
By Jove. I know that horse. That's
That Stringybark, the racehorse.
See, what did I tell you?
Oh, Stringybark, eh? Well, I'll be damned. Yeah. He's a Nundle gift winner, you know. Won a lot of money on him once.
I told you I knew a good horse when I saw one, didn't I?
You sure he's Stringybark, sir?
My boy, I've been around country race meetings all my life, and I never forget a face. Old Stringybark, eh? He's quite a stayer in his time. You'll be racing, I expect it.
Oh, yes, of course, yes. The next picnic race meeting that we strike, well...
Oh, good day.
Only one problem, Pop. Who's going to ride him?
You, of course, boy. You.
Morning, Mr. Pym.
What's that mount you got there? Here he's a bit of a dark horse.
You might be surprised. He's quite a stayer.
Stayed around a bit too long, if you ask me. Got to see a man about a horse.
Good luck.
Worm.
It'll be over very quickly.
That's what they said to the early Christians.
Carmen. Nice mount.
Wonder if it's spot.
Carmen, try the one. 200 to 1. Stringybark. 200 to 1. Aristocrat.
Prince Carmen. 6 to 1.
Lovely horse, guaranteed lady to win tomorrow.
And now we come to the Bungally Cup. The cup and the other prizes will be presented by one of the district's finest fillies, my young sister, who, as some of you no doubt know, has won fame both here and abroad as a dancer in the modern style.
Come on. Awesome.
to be disqualified. And the winner is... Come.
Written by L. Lockhart. Nothing like keeping it in the family, eh?
Congratulations. Thank you.
And the second place goes to Aristocrat, written by P. Palmer.
Congratulations, Mr. Palmer.
Thank you, ma'am.
You have the choice of a bridal or a lady's bracelet.
Take the lady's bracelet.
Some lady is going to be very pleased.
You can bet on that, ma'am.
$600, $700, $800. Thank you.
$10.
It's great race,
isn't
it?
Great race. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Is he dead?
He's as dead as mutton. It's his heart. No, Bugger was as old as God.
You and your bloody bargains.
What a waste of money.
How to hit, when to hit, and where to hit. You planning on hitting anybody in particular?
You never know.
Ah.
All in the footwork. Oh, one, two. One, two. Oh. You ought to take it up.
That's not my kind of sport. Might spoil my feet for playing the piano.
Right. You've got to do something on the road.
Yeah. You must get pretty lonely on the road without friends of your own age.
Yeah. All these one-night stands, I just don't have a chance.
Ah. Things will be different when your father gets his permanent theatre.
See you. Did you drop a gum leaf in it?
Well, I am a bushy now, you know.
Shh, don't wake him.
No.
You make friends easily, Freddy.
Yeah. Well, if I can give you a bit of advice, perhaps.
Yes, please.
As someone who's travelled around the world a bit. When you meet somebody that you like, it's a bit like showbiz. You've got to get in there pitching.
Well, anyhow, if I did meet a girl... Well, look at me. I'm hardly a jazzy dresser.
Well, doesn't he pay you?
He still pays me pocket money.
Well, the show seems to do good business.
Yeah. Well, it's not hard to make a few bob with travelling pictures. Not much entertainment in these little towns.
Come on. Here, boy. Here. Come on. Shh. Shoo. Come on. Come on.
Can't take any more passengers.
He's starving.
Well, what beats me is where he came from. There's not a homestead around here for miles.
Well, he must be a stray.
I don't know where he's come from, but it looks as if he's staying. Welcome to Pim's Pictures on Tour.
I did the other day at the races.
Rotten luck about your horse.
He certainly made a good exit.
Coming in for a dip?
I was. I haven't got a swimming costume.
Well, neither have I. I won't look. It's freezing, but all right once you're in.
From the town?
I live here.
What do you mean?
This is our place. Lucy Lockhart, Coolable Station.
Larry Pym, of Pym's Pictures on Tour.
What a fascinating life you must have.
Well,
I mean, fancy seeing Gloria Swanson every night. I think she's terrific.
She's not half as pretty as you. I think you're the prettiest girl I've ever seen in my entire life.
Hey, boy, come on. Come on over here. Come on, Brady. Come on. Come on, Brady. Yes. Come on. Yes. Well, what did I tell you? Thief!
He says I'm a thief.
This is my dog.
His dog?
I didn't know you had a dog, Pete.
Larry, listen to me. Dogs come and dogs go, but that there is my dog.
But we found him.
I found him.
We found him.
He wandered into our camp,
starving in the bush.
Left to die. Now, if, as you claim, that is your dog, you've been up to your usual form, sneaking up behind me.
I go where I damn well please.
Poaching on my territory?
Yours? I'm a businessman. Not like some people I know.
I, sir, am a showman and proud of it.
You're a two-faced old blowhard.
I show pictures. I do not show off horses. For horses. Ostentatious upstart.
Austin? You calling me a phony?
Yes, I am.
That does it.
Ah! Bring it, older man. You imitation Tom Mix.
Tom Mix?
You green puff.
Watch your footwork, Freddy. Watch your footwork. Come on, Freddy. Watch your footwork, mate.
Kim,
will you get him away from me?
It's you and me.
Your footwork, Freddy.
Now, it's you and me, Pim. Come on, Pim!
Him!
Get on the wagon.
Ready? Come on. Get up there.
Hey, Pim, remember you started this.
Not exactly what I had in mind. I was looking for something more substantial in a bigger town.
A lot of potential in the town, Mr. Pym. No regular picture show here since the last proprietor.
Fire. What happened to the poor blighter?
Done to a crisp.
It looks in pretty good nick, Pop. An electric generator?
A 240-volt generator coupled to a one-lunger DD and petrol engine.
Aren't those things unreliable?
Not the DDians, Mr. Pym. From the DDian car, you know. Perfect for running a picture show. The lad here could learn to work in a no time.
Well, the size of this town, there is only one night that you can rely on. That is Saturday night. And as there's only one Saturday night every week, more's the pity, I do not think that there would be enough to support the three of us.
Listen. Why don't you give a lad a go by himself?
Oh, yes, Pop. Please.
We could keep on going around the circuit, same as we have before. And that way, nobody's going to lose anything.
Yes, well, that would mean that you would have to be both business manager and operator, and I don't think that you're up to it, sir.
Oh, of course he's up to it. Everybody has to learn how to stand on their own feet sometime.
I'm sure your son would be very capable, Mr. Pym, and the committee would give him all the help he needs. A lady pianist, for one thing.
Thank you.
My name is Pym. This is Freddie Graves. We're in moving pictures.
Fitzwilliam.
My partner, Madame Cavalli.
We're in debt.
Mr. Pym?
Ran out of petrol.
That is one thing about horses. They never run out of petrol.
True, true. Oats, perhaps, but not petrol.
A lot of so-called stage managers should be run out of the business. I've seen a lot of sad cases in my time, players marooned in strange towns, broke, friendless.
There, my dear Pym, you sum up our situation precisely.
Ours is a very modest outfit. We stick to smaller towns. But if you and Madame would consider joining us until you get on your feet.
Oh, Mr. Pym.
Accepted with pleasure, Pym. We have several outstanding acts, you know. Apart from the trivia that you witnessed earlier, I think you will find our mind-reading speciality a splendid draw card.
Summer stew, Mr. Pym.
Oh, you've read my mind, Madame.
Thank you, sir.
Maurice.
Francesca.
Madame is an excellent cook, you know. Although some people might say that she uses too much garlic.
I'm not complaining.
Well, as a matter of fact, I'm very fond of garlic.
Good.
In show business, have a tradition to keep up. Carry on through thick and thin.
The show must go on and all that.
Of course, it's no different with the man on the land. If our show stops, whole country collapses. Farmers, salt of the earth.
Personally, I'm all for picture people. They're good customers of ours.
Customers?
Our hall in the rivers where I live. The committee have managed to wipe off the overdraft with picture bookings. Do you ever play the rivers, Larry?
The rivers? No.
It's good showman territory. The towns are much closer together than here. And they pay their bills. That's why I took my school there. Not like these parts. Graziers living on mortgages. Oh.
Well, we might give it a try. I haven't had much luck in these parts.
Watch out for her, though, when she gets you on those stock horses.
My daughter can cut cattle or rope a heifer. Just about anything a young man can do.
Well, not quite everything, Father.
I brought my daughter up as a boy. I don't want to have her dependent on some damn fool of a man. No, sir. My daughter can open and shut her own gates, as we say in the country.
And she wants no favors from men.
we are proud to present the great Cabalis. Ladies and gentlemen, we thank you for your gracious welcome. I am about to walk amongst you and distribute slips of paper on which you may write a question you would like to ask Madame. Please append your initials for identification. The slips of paper will then be placed into this bag and burnt in full view of you all. By means of her extraordinary methods of thought transference, Madame will identify both the question and the initial, and then give the answer. Madame also has the ability to see into the future, but I must warn you to think carefully before you ask about the future. It can be a dangerous thing to know the future. Ask only if you have the courage to face the answer.
I see the initials WJ. I see the question. What is in my top pocket? In your top pocket, there is a pencil, a handkerchief. But you also have a secret in your top pocket. That is a picture of your secret love.
I bet that caused a bit of a stir. Next, initials LM. Will I get married? Same old question.
Someone with initials LM. I think that is a young lady, yes? See a man, a young man. But whether he will be your husband or your lover, I cannot see. No, beyond the man, I cannot see. The next question, this question, I will not say it. Just answer it. The initials are M.P.
They're not the initials.
I see a dark stranger in your life. Romance. It could be love.
About those ad-libs. Who was it this time?
The audience likes a little mystery.
As you like a little affair, eh?
As you like a little drink. You should be careful with that.
In these conditions, it is a medicinal necessity.
But it makes you so like a beast.
Nonsense. I'm as gentle as a lamb. It's the poor quality of this damned local fire water. Now, a Dimple Hague.
Where am I to get the money to pay for it? Pluck it out of the air?
I can think of an easier place for you to pluck it from.
That's the end of all that.
But you'll be going on somewhere else.
I especially wanted to make a go of it here.
Oh, this is just a one-horse town. You've got to find somewhere bigger.
But Pop won't...
Look, never mind your father. Do it by yourself.
Lucy, would you consider...
Consider what?
Do you agree with what your father said?
Well, I certainly don't agree about everything he says. About what?
About not being dependent on a man.
Of course I do. It's crazy to think that a girl's only hope is to marry some man. That doesn't mean...
What?
That I'd never marry. Or anything like that.
If your father wants to treat you as a boy, that's entirely up to him. But as far as I'm concerned, you're a girl.
Me.
You'll take care of me when I leave
him. Oh, put your money on me, Dreamboat. I've been a stay-at-the-way back.
run for it.
Let's all sing a little song while we're waiting. Tap, tap.
We feel that you are still in love with me.
It will be all right.
I don't want it like this anymore. I don't like it like this anymore.
It will be
about the open-air show.
Takings weren't too bad.
No, no, it's not your fault, son. It ought to be a large centre, you know. It should be done properly. Soft drinks, sweets.
Usherettes.
Decent piano. Manager's office.
Mr. Pym? Larry?
Farmer?
Still making it big at the box office? By the way, Mr. Pym, real sorry you lost your star attraction.
Houdini and his missus.
Houdini and his wife.
They had another offer.
Well, that's gratitude for you. After all Mr. Pym did for him.
Well, those damn foreigners, you can't trust any of them.
Mr. Pym, with all due respect, let me give you a little piece of advice. You just didn't pay him enough. That's how you lost your biggest asset. Me, remember? Morning, Mr. Pym. Drive on, Lewis.
That ass? An asset? He thinks he was an asset? He can't even sing.
But he makes more money than we do.
I wouldn't say that.
Well, can we afford a motor van? Well, how much is in the kitty?
It's gone.
Gone?
For most. Apart from last night's takings.
I always said you'd be better off with a bank, Pop.
There's no fool like an old fool.
You're a bloody old fool if you don't go to the police.
No. That'll be a waste of time. The thief couldn't be anywhere by now. Get a move on.
Well, what's the use? Palmer's going to get their way ahead of us.
No, we've gone through all the playable towns we can, as far west as we could go. It's mostly desert after that.
One circuit we haven't tried. Mm-hmm. The rivers.
What sort of country?
Dairying, sugarcane, tropical fruits.
Tropical? The rivers is east, isn't it?
Well, where are we going?
Wacko! Come on, get around there!
Put some more muscle into it, boy.
Get into it, lad. Good view. Not worth stopping for. Like you need a hand, son.
Not from you.
Keep it down, dog.
Easy, Freddy.
Listen. When are you going to leave this two-bit outfit and come work with me?
You've got a hide turning up here.
Hasn't your dad ever told you this is a free country?
We came here to get away from you. We left you with a clear territory.
Now, listen, this is a proposition. Why don't you come and join me?
What about Lou?
Oh, I'm just a driver now. Well, I help out with the projecting, you know.
Just a driver? No, I'm serious. You and me would be pretty good together.
What about Pop? What about Freddy, eh? You just ditch him.
Let me tell you, them piano players are all finished. And silent movies are all finished. It's gonna be singing, talking and dancing right up there on the silver screen. When you change your mind, let me know.
Get out of here. Get out of this territory.
Talkies. Just a passing fad.
You ought to be in pictures.
Yes, you ought.
Phototone, Rakophone, Western Electric.
Which is the best?
It doesn't really matter.
We can't pay for them and Pop won't.
Within a few short months, 95% of Australian showmen will be forced to wire for sound or walk out.
Yes, that makes me a victim of the march of progress.
Oh, Freddie.
No, it can't happen.
It can't, Freddie.
Don't worry. Your old friend Freddie doesn't intend to end up on the scrap heap of history yet. Would they take a deposit?
Western Electric can help you finance this important and necessary step.
Freddie, where did you get it?
Well, it's your fault. You started it. Your horse, Carmen.
The body is an instrument. An instrument of art. Clouds moving across the sky. A tree waving its branches in the wind. Now, girls, branches! Now, a bird in flight! Eleanor, where are you going?
You tonight for their talkie premiere.
Only one way to sort this out.
Isabel, the minute book. Respond, Marjorie, respond. Feel the music flowing through you. We have beautiful bodies. We must learn how to use them.
Nothing for Palmer.
Couldn't be, my dear. We haven't had a meeting since then.
I'm going to warn Larry.
It's Mr. Palmer.
I was looking for the hall secretary, but maybe we'd better wait behind over there.
You're welcome to watch the class.
I sure would like to, but we've got things to do. Ladies?
like you've mixed up your bookings, doesn't it?
We haven't.
Are you calling me a liar?
I'm not calling you a liar, Palmer. You are a liar. You couldn't even lie straight in bed.
That does it again! Stop!
This time you're
Good afternoon. Madame.
Well, now, ladies, we don't want to bother you with our business.
Oh, but it is our business, Mr. Palmer.
You happen to be talking to the chairman of the hall committee.
No, wait a minute. Now, you see, I've already paid the hall secretary.
What's that, Mr. Palmer? You paid the secretary? But we don't ask for payment in advance at this hall.
Well, this looks more like a police matter.
Yes. That might explain a few other things that have been happening around here.
Oh! Who, oh, you bloody idiot!
Insured, I presume? Nowhere near its value. There's a fortune in equipment in there. Could I help? Can you help? How, Mr. Rockefeller?
I'd like to make you an offer.
As it stands?
Shall we say, as it lies?
We have just bought out our rival. We've bought ourselves a talkie bus with two of the latest sound on disc projectors. Discs thrown in.
Well, what about all the other stuff?
Pop, I'm leaving. I'm leaving the show.
You can't do that.
Can't I? Tell me why not.
Just when Pym's pictures are about to take off like a bushfire?
Mr. Pym, do you realize that Larry hasn't lived in a house since he left school?
Of course not, girlie. This is a touring show. What's a house got to do with it anyway?
Everything! Look, I am fed up with knocking around the countryside like a gypsy. I'm fed up with never being able to see any of the friends I make. And I am fed up with always being with you.
It's just that he's never going to be anyone till he's away from you, Mr. Pym. You're too big for him.
Oh, and I've made myself a promise.
Oh, what is it?
I'm never going to eat one of your rabbit stews again.
What are you going to do, boy?
What you've been saying for years you want to do.
We're going to find a picture theatre. Going into partnership.
Who is going to pay for it?
You're going to give me some of that back pay you've owed me for years.
But why now, son? My boy, I mean, why when we've got Palmer wriggling like a cut snake?
Well, it looks as if Larry and Lucy are set.
Don't like their chances. Not too much hope for independence these days. Those exchanges will eat it for breakfast. Send him a bill for indigestion powders.
Well, what about you, then? You'll have to make a fresh start.
I was going to junk that lot anyway.
Really?
Got my eye on something a little more advanced. Something I've been kind of thinking about ever since I jumped ship years ago.
You're a man with an interesting past, Mr. Palmer.
And an even more interesting future, Miss Lockhart.
Did you call, dear?
Time is getting on.
Will you be back early in the morning?
It may be quite late. Snake bites require special attention.
Oh, but your cough, dear. Is it wise to stay out in the open?
I shall feel more lonely than you will, Marion.
He's gone.
Is it quite safe? Does he suspect?
Oh, forget him. He can think of nothing but these reptiles that he studies. But you love me, don't you, Dick?
Yes, darling.
And you will never leave me.
I'm afraid I must.
Dick!
I've received instructions to go to Johnstall.
Get there! When?
Tomorrow. It's the truth.
Then this is the last time.
The very last. For the present.
Oh, but I love you, Dick. There can be no happiness without you.
We shall meet again in the hills when summer comes. 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 When summer comes.
When summer comes.
Side in spirit.